fine, in UMA Telo, okay, UMA home phone service, you know, usually introduction it is same, but what we are going to do is, if you are speaking only for UMA, you will be using the introduction as given here. Hi, this is Sam from UMA home phone service, how are you doing today? That is different. But you are going to dial for Canadian telecom service, so UMA is also included in that, right? As short direct, UMA Telo and CAK internet, everything is included in Canadian telecom service. So what you are going to do is, you are just going to speak the introduction as, hi, this is Sam from Canadian telecom service, how are you doing today? That is what your usual dialogue will be, okay. Then acknowledgement, you know it very well. So acknowledgement, it is common for all the services. You'll be using the first time acknowledgement here for asking how are you doing today or how are you. You'll be using this kind of acknowledgement only for one time, okay. Yeah, let us move on to the third point. Pitching the promotion is there, right? Any one of you guys in the first row, kindly read that point.
I also have an exciting offer for your home phone, where you can make unlimited calls all over Canada for just $14 a month with the 35 calling features.
Okay, kindly read it once again.
I also have an exciting offer for your
phone. Okay, you have written this or you have it on your print?
I have
because
print.
I'm seeing here, like, the reason why I'm calling you is in that way it starts actually. So that is why I was both are okay. Fine, you know, previously we have a great offer or an exciting offer for television, right? For television promotions, so we should not, we don't need to use the same dialogue all, here also. You know, it will be a robotic thing, like, you know, using the same dialogue for every service. Okay, so let us make a change here. I will send this script also for you. Okay, it's a slight change. The reason why I'm calling you is, like, means, like, you know, we are not calling at this point of time. We'll be speaking the television part first, then we are speaking about the UMA Telo, right? This is only for UMA they have written. So don't worry, what you have said is okay. What you have said is correct thing, okay. But instead of exciting, for example, previously for television, if you are using an exciting offer, now you can tell them, like, I have a great offer for your home phone, okay. Likewise, you can just change any one of the word there and you can just use it, okay.
Yes, tell me,
please.
The reason why I am calling you is to inform you that I have a great offer for your home phone, where you can make unlimited calls all over Canada for just $14 a month with 35 calling features.
Okay, this is what it is there in your script, but he said he read something different, right?
Yes, yes, sir.
Fine, but okay. But what he read is, that is okay. You know, the script which you are having, the same thing which I have it on my screen.
Yes.
This is for the people who they dial only for UMA Telo. Okay.
Yes.
At the time, you know, what they will do is, like, you know, greeting is completed, acknowledgement is completed. They are telling the reason for call. But now what we are doing is, we are dialing for Canadian telecom service. Already we have said why we are calling. Okay. In television package itself. You know, we have a great offer for our television, for your television and all. We have done it. So what we can do is, as the first guy read, we can use that thing. I have an exciting offer for your home phone too. Or otherwise, I have a great offer for your home phone too, where you can make unlimited calls all over Canada and US. Likewise, you can just speak the dialogue. Okay, in this way you can do it. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Fine. So let me read it once for you. I have a great offer for your home phone too, where you can make unlimited calls all over Canada and US. If you want, you can add and US also for just $14 a month. Okay, for $14 a month, you have to mention this. Okay, with 35 calling features. Okay, I use proper modulation. Like, sorry, you use proper pass for just $14 a month with 35 calling features. Likewise, you can tell to the customer. Okay, calling features, relating calling features, you can just look into the website and you can gain knowledge on that. Okay. And now, as you know very well, already we have reconfirmed or confirmed the service provider while we are speaking about the television also. But if they are telling, I'm using Bell Canada for my TV, internet and landline. Okay, that means okay, that is well and good. But if they are telling for television alone, you can once again ask the customer at that time itself. You can ask them, once you finish the promotion related sixth point, immediately you can ask them, you are using your television, not only your television with Bell Canada, you are using your home phone and internet also with Bell Canada, right? Likewise, you can ask Bell Canada or Rogers, whatever. After that, you can move for explaining the promotion. Okay. Yeah, the basic pricing you know very well, right? Like as I said before, you can, you know, it is not must, like, you know, definitely you should not use, as I said before, for television, and again as I said before for home phone also. You can slightly change the dialogue if you want. Okay. Like, you know, here it has been mentioned, as I said before, you can make unlimited calls all over Canada for just $14 a month with 35 calling features, and this price will, this pricing will be for the first 1 year. This is the good news for the customer. Just $14, that sustains for 1 year completely. Every month they will be paying just $14 alone. The price will not hike because this is the discounted price for the customer, and after that it will be $19 forever. Okay, so $90 is also that is also you know, very cheapest price for this service. Okay, and that is forever. The price will be forever. The customer they don't need to pay higher money after that. Okay, so that's why we are telling forever, and there is no time limit on unlimited calling. You can enjoy 24/7. Okay, this is the next point you have to tell to the customer after getting the acknowledgement, after getting the answer from the customer. Okay. Up to $19.99 forever you are speaking, and you can ask them, that sounds good, right, or okay, or something like that. You can ask, then you can move forward. There is no time limit on unlimited calling. You can enjoy 24/7. Okay, if the customer is not answering anything, you can just continue the dialogue. There is no time limit on unlimited calling. Like this, you can just continue it. And then the best part is, the best part here is, you can make calls through Uma mobile app with the same calling plan even if you are out of your house without any additional charges. That means, like, you know, we have seen enough things relating Uma mobile app. Okay, you can speak about connecting with 5 mobile apps and they can reduce the mobile phone bills with this landline package. Okay, with this $14 they can reduce their smartphone bills also up to 80% or 90%, they can reduce it. Okay, then you have to explain it very clearly. If you couldn't explain, you can transfer the call, you can ask your senior agent to handle the call. But it is always good for you to practice by yourself, try to speak from your side. Okay, practice hard and try to speak from your side. If it is collapsing, don't worry. If you are missing the sales, don't worry. You are learning how not to miss a sale from the next time. Okay, so if you are missing the sale, don't get upset. Okay, that is a lesson for you. Okay, you will start thinking how to not how you should not lose the customer. In that way, your brain will start thinking. Okay, you will try hard after that. Okay, so speak with confidence. Okay, fine. And the last one relating this is, I have a good news for you. You will not be paying any shipping charges for Uma device. So Uma device, we are getting the charge for the Uma device. They are purchasing it. Okay, but for shipping it is free only. Okay, shipping charges is completely free. Charges are that is free, and I'm sure that the prices will not hike in future. This is the additional point. You know, relating home phone, we have less thing to speak. Okay, we are not giving any free devices, right? So what we can do is, we can tell them, the prices will not hike in future. So there is a price guarantee we are giving, so the customer will be happy on that. Okay, we are just going to pay, already they might be paying $30 or $25 for their existing service provider, but for 1 year nearly they can save $10 to $15. Okay, every month. Okay, for example, if they are saying they are paying $25, for example. Okay, what you can tell them, as Vijay asked, how to compare the things with the customer, you are asking the customer, you know, how much you are paying for your home phone. You can ask them, here, you know, they are telling $25 for my Bell Canada, I am paying for only for home phone. Okay, what you can tell is, like, you know, for just $14 you can make unlimited calls 24/7. Okay, that too for Canada, USA and Mexico, and you will be getting this Uma app also, and every month you can save nearly $10. That means like in a year you are saving nearly $120. Okay, that's not a small money, right? Everything is hard earned money from your side, right? So you can save $120 in a year. Okay, in that way you can guide the customer. You can compare their service to with our service. Okay, and I'm sure that the prices will not hike in future that you are telling, and you are asking, I hope you are interested with this package. This is the usual dialogue. Wherever it is necessary, you can just ask, and then you can proceed further with the customer. And you know, the seventh point, it is common point. If the customer is living for television, if you are asking whether they live in an apartment or whatever, the same applies for all the services. Only one time you are going to use the seventh point. Okay, you got it right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. And relating the booking, the package, we can see it later, and you know how to collect the date of birth, right? Come to the 10th point. Come to the, 9th point, email ID. So here it is Uma Tello, right? Yeah. So relating Uma Tello, in the 9th point, it is mentioned as CAK, right? Change it as Uma Tello. Okay. Yeah, so that is Uma Tello. Yes, I have also changed it. Uma is a paperless company. Whatever you the company, you can tell them, like Canadian Telecom Services, paperless company, like this also you can tell. Okay, so Uma is a paperless company, so we send all the details, billings and other and everything through email. So may I know your email ID? If you are asking the email ID in this way, you know, they will definitely give you, because you have to send the billings and other details, right? So you are just, you know, what is that everything? There is nothing. To make a conversation, like, you know, they might be asking, is there any contract, is there any agreement for the price guarantee? They will be asking, right? So that is the hidden thing, like details, billing and everything through email. We do everything through email. Since it is paperless company, that is the only reason we are asking for email ID, because they will ask, they should not ask you. After, you know, if you are blindly, you know, if you are just asking, what is your email ID? A direct question to the customer should not be asked. Okay. If you are telling this reason and if you are asking, definitely they will provide the email ID. Okay. So like you can just ask, you know, Canadian Telecom Service is a paperless company. So can I get your email ID please? To send all these details, billings and everything. Okay, likewise you can just speak with them. And relating the date of birth, I know I'm speaking with the person who is above 18. This is very important, like, you know, when you're getting the date of birth, just don't ask them, may I know your date of birth? Okay. You know, tell some reason, like, you know, reason or some convincing point. I know, how I speak is, while I'm speaking, I can understand, like you're above 18. But still, for the confirmation, I just want to confirm it from your side. Like, may I know your date of birth, please? Okay. It should be in a flow. Okay. It might be like, they should think like you're hesitating to ask, but for the conversation, confirmation only you're asking. So in that way, it should be polite, and they should think, okay, this guy is hesitating, but it is needed. That is why he is asking. He's not going to do any cheating work with the data birth at all. Likewise, they have to think. The tone should be moderating in that way, in such a way. Okay. So, I know I'm speaking with a person who is above 18, but still for the confirmation, may I know your date of birth, please? Likewise, you can ask. And then if the customer is giving, well and good. If the customer is not giving their date of birth, if they're giving a negative reply, see that there are two points here, A and B. No, it is not like that. I will explain to you clearly. Fine. Before going to A point or B point, okay, tell the acknowledge the customer. Okay, the customer is telling, why do you want to know about that? Why are you asking my date of birth? You know, immediately, you know, if you are if you are forcing the customer to tell their date of birth, you know, they will hang up the call. Okay, so that is a proper thing, proper ways to handle the customer. Okay, that is, no, it's not like that. I will explain you clearly. Okay, then after using this acknowledgement, then you can go to A point. That is, this package is valuable one. This offer is only for the selected customers, not for all. Okay, that means the package is only for the selected customers, not for all. That means like the customer, we are treating the customer as a special customer, and they should not lose this package. Okay. For that only we are confirming this data book from their side. I will read it completely for you. This package is valuable one because we are giving free Wi-Fi device, free high definition personal video recorder. We are giving the price guarantee for Umatello. Okay. So these things are there. So it is not for all customers, only for the selected customer. You are the one. You are one among that valuable customer. That is what you are trying to tell to the customer. So the package should reach to the right person. That is what the point you are telling to the customer. It should reach to the right person. Otherwise, you know, some other customer, if they are taking, that is not suitable for them. Okay, it won't suit them. Okay, the offer might be misused. So we have to give it to the selected customers only. So that is the reason to verify it from your side. I'm just asking your date of birth. That is what we have to tell to the customer. That's the reason I'm asking your date of birth. And let us see what we are seeing in the B point. It is an optional point. You can use either A or B. Okay, B is like, it's just to confirm that you are above 18, who is qualified for this offer. Nothing more than that. Likewise, you can speak. And C point. This is also optional point. Any one of these points, A or B or C, you can use. Don't use all the. You can use all the things also. If the customer is denying again, if they're giving the same negative reply again, you can just try to convince the customer again. Okay, that is like we value our customer safety first. Your information will be entered in the encrypted form, so it cannot be accessed again. Okay, it cannot be accessed again. That is very important. You are telling to the customer, it's just to check you are above 18. It is just to check you are above 18. Okay, even then if the customer is not giving, tell the customer to process this order to the next level. You know, I need any one of the ID. So I hope you can understand. Likewise, you can tell the customer. Okay, try to get the data. Okay, fine. Alternate number, as you know very well, the next calls will be going through manual dialing. Okay, so alternate number is must. So if in case, you know, already we have seen yesterday itself, if in case if I couldn't reach your home phone number, is there any alternate number like mobile phone number or cell phone number? You can use this 11th dialogue on hold. Okay, don't use that 11th dialogue which we have seen on the short direct. Okay, use this dialogue, it will be perfect for all calls. Okay, like mobile number or cell phone number. Okay, this last two, three words are in addition here. Fine, and mode of payment, you know it, right? The same thing. Okay, date of birth, sorry, credit card or debit card, master or visa, these things already we have seen on short direct. Okay, so whenever you want to see some reference, you always see short direct YouTube video first. Then come to this Umatello. Okay, only then you can, you know, because you guys are going to speak for all the three services, right? Okay. Yeah, so if you are coming in order, you can easily understand. So whatever the information we are providing, that will be entered in the encrypted form. Okay. And the last one, sorry, just give me a moment. Home phone number confirmation. You know how to convince the customer, sorry, how to confirm it from the home phone. Sorry, home phone confirmation means like it is written in 13th point. Don't worry, you know, when you are finishing up, when you are starting booking the package, that is 8th point. There itself, you can start this confirmation of home phone number. Okay, I would like to confirm your home phone number. It is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 1, right? Likewise, you can just say this, then you can start collecting their details, or you can confirm their last name, first name, and all. And the last part is, as you know, commitment. Okay, all these dialogues, the verification dialogues or whatever, you will be using only one time on call. Okay, we will be having a very quick review with Canadian Telecom Service, that whole script. Okay, at that time you can understand what are the total number of things. We are not going to speak 15 points in television, 15 points in Umatello, and 15 points in CAK. Don't worry on that. Okay, you will be maximum speaking nearly like 20 to 22 points. Okay, that will just go in a flow. You don't need to worry about those things. It is not like big conversation, or it is matter of 5 to 7 minutes. A call is like 5 to 7 minutes. A quality sale happens in 5 to 7 minutes, and we are just closing the call for any service. Like, you know, thanks for choosing Umatello, or thanks for choosing Canadian Telecom Service. Okay, even if the customer is saying just two service, you can just close the call as thanks for choosing Tech Canada in telecom service. And you know, you'll be usually saying some other dialogue, right? Our verification team will be calling you within 24 hours. So that dialogue is must. You should not leave it. Definitely you have to get it from the customer. The important point here, which is relating the UMA Telo, you can see the note now. Okay. In the note, customer home phone account number for the payment. That is, customer home phone account number is must. Okay. If they are porting the number, it is definitely needed. Okay. Please advise the customer. He is not, you know, if he is not knowing where is the home phone account number, not the phone number, home phone account number. Okay, billing number, previous billing number. That time, what you have to do is, like, you can ask them to check it in the previous bill. That is their invoice. For porting number, home phone number, the same home phone number, you have to note it down. Already you will be having on the CRM page. You don't need to worry about that. And current service provider, you should definitely ask the current service provider. If you are missing out for the television also, that is different. Okay, we can ask once again. But if you are missing out the information for UMA Telo, you know, it cannot be proceeded. You know, it cannot be processed to the next level. Definitely, you should know who is their current service provider when they are porting the number. Okay. And it is always must. Okay, you can think in that way. Customer home phone account number, that is what, you know, home phone number, home phone account number, current service provider of theirs. Okay, and the same thing applies here. 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. is the installation time. Okay, so this is how we have to handle the UMA Telo. Okay, right from the first, you know, there are so many common points. Neglect the common points. Only use UMA Telo when you are speaking UMA Telo points, while you are speaking UMA Telo. Okay, don't speak about shipping charges for television. There is no shipping charges for television. Okay, don't get confused and don't speak about, you know, you'll be having a, you know, there is no shipping charges for your short direct television. Likewise, definitely don't speak. There is no logic. Okay, because the technicians will be carrying the dish antenna. Okay. So there is no logic in speaking about shipping charges for television. Okay, and don't speak about modem for UMA Telo. Okay, UMA Telo is not giving modem, it is giving UMA device. UMA device is different from CAK modem. Don't get confused. Okay, so be clear in whatever you are speaking. That will be good in making the sales for all the three services. Okay, that is what my point is. I just wanted to inform you. Okay, don't forget to keep the PowerPoint when you are dialing. That is very important. Okay, guys.